Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
If you love me, I'll be waiting at home. If you don't leave me alone. If you want me, tell me. If you love me, don't let me go.
My name's Annie, and I am a breeder and huge enthusiast of the County Corso Italian Mastiff. And I also have a Belgian Malinois. I have my older female, her name's Nasa. She's 7 years old. And then I have her daughter, her name's Rania, and she is 10 months old. And then Jax, my Malinois, is just under 2. I love the Cane Corso mostly because it's a breed that really wants to work with you and is like very bonded to its handler or owner. I show my dogs an AKC confirmation mostly because I'm a competitive person and I enjoy that aspect of it. I think that the AKC show ring is a good place to learn about canine structure and movement and the type of the breed and kind of all the things that make up the look of the dog. In the AKC show ring, I've finished several dogs. NASA has a grand championship. I finished several dogs that I bred. And last year I campaigned a dog who is out of NASA. His name is Cash. Cash got up to, I want to say, number 7 in the rankings nationally, and he was the first dog that I ever got some group placements on, so that was really exciting for me. At its essence, the Cane Corso is a powerfully built dog that is really biddable, like I said before, really wants to work with its person. I do enjoy showing my dogs an AKC in the show ring, for sure. It's fun. But I really think it's important, as far as the overall dog goes, to venture outside of that and to demonstrate their working abilities too. Like, you know, there's only so much running to the left in circles that really, you know, you can do. So I think it's very important to get out and try working towards different things with the dogs in a capacity that tests their physical and mental traits. They need a certain amount of correct structure to make it through the different sports. They need to be sound, they need to be built right, but the working really does prove kind of what they can do outside of that, what else they're capable of. A complete dog obviously is more than just what it looks like, and that's why I think it's important to work them and to test their workability, and not just to get titles, but also because when you work with your dog a lot towards something, you learn more about that dog all the time. So when I come out here and track, I learn how long will my dog keep going for before he quits. I learn all kinds of different things about them through the training, which I think is really important as a breeder. You should always be evaluating your own dogs. I work my dogs in IPO, which is a protection sport. And what I really, really like about the sport is that it's not just about biting and protection. As exciting as that is, don't get me wrong, it is exciting, but it's a three-phase sport. So it has obedience. Part of that obedience component is agility. There's jumping, there's a scale wall, and then there's tracking. And those three phases together, I think, are really interesting because they test and show so many different sides of the dog. And then with my older dog, after she finished her IPO3, I started to kind of play a little more in the AKC obedience competition. So she's working towards her utility dog, which is, you know, something I'll be really interested to see see how that goes. The exercises are a little different than things she knows, so there's a lot of retraining. And one of those things is the scent discrimination exercises. Scent discrimination, the premise is that your dog can pick out your scent out of some items that all look identical for all intents and purposes. So you have an article. In my case, I just use dumbbells because I have a big dog. But you can use lots of different things. It can be wooden dowels or can lids or anything like that. Basically, it has to be two different types of materials. So I choose leather and metal, but you can use wood also. And I just set out the articles, and then I will choose one to scent. I put my scent on it just by rubbing it, and then I place it somewhere among the other articles that look identical, and then she goes and she finds my scent and picks up that item and brings it back to me. So in tracking, like, the scent that they pick up and indicate on the articles is a cold scent. Like, you lay the track and then run it, you know, it can be several hours later. So that's a cold scent, whereas with a scent discrimination, it's a hot scent. So it was a challenge for her to kind of relearn what scent she's discriminating. So again, that was just tough for her mentally, and I like the idea of my old dog learning something new. I thought that was pretty cool. Tracking is one third of the sport of IPO. It's one of the phases, and it involves the dog tracking a scent. Since it's for competition, it's a little bit more stylized than just finding stuff. It's very much about how the dog searches, and being really methodical in the searching is really important. I go out and I lay a track, which just involves me walking. And on the track, I drop certain personal items. I just use little leather or felt or wood, whatever, things to mimic, like, you know, if someone dropped a wallet or a piece of someone's jeans. And then my dog goes out and follows that track and indicates when it finds those articles. In the sport of IPO, your dog may indicate however you choose. My dog's down at the article, so they will locate the item and then put it between their paws and kind of stare at it. That's our indication. It's pretty common, but you can choose to do it a variety of different ways. I think the greatest benefit outside of kind of proving their capabilities is that it really is mentally exhausting for the dogs. You know, most of it is just walking, so it's not about them running really hard or jumping, but it's really mentally exhausting. Like, they will get off a track and go straight to sleep. Jack's my Malinois. I just got a couple months ago, and he's close to two. So we're just kind of starting out and figuring out how we're gonna train and kind of our relationship. He's a really, really neat dog. Lots of drive, willingness to work, and biddable, and yeah, all that good stuff that you want in a dog. The Malinois I got because through the kind of course I became really interested in the sport of IPO. The main differences between the Cane Corso and the Malinois are that the Corso is generally a larger dog. The Malinois is a little bit slighter, less weight. Temperament-wise, the Malinois just has a lot more drive than your average Corso. Kind of dabbling in the competition side of it, so I got him to kind of check that out, or kind of be, you know, hopefully try and be a little more competitive with him. He's a really good dog, and yeah, we'll see how that goes.
If you love me, I'll be waiting at home. If you don't leave me on. If you want me, tell me, I need to know.
I love coming out here to work with my dogs. It's a great way to get out of the city. It's quiet, you know, take your time. It's not a schedule. It's very peaceful to just lay your track, walk behind your dog, and watch them work. It's great.
I make my way in the world, and I can make If you love me, don't